Okay, in this video we're going to use this small powerful charge servo to activate the puffer jets from the Harrier. And these are as called the roll nozzles, and these are actually needed to keep the model stable during hover for rolling motion. Look how small it is. And in this video we got a lot of work to do to finish the version 2 Harrier. So we're going to work on the fuselage, we're going to prepare the wing, and we got really something special what's on the end of the video, which is pretty much kill. So make sure to subscribe and like this video, lean back, take a cup of coffee and enjoy this build.
If I were to put the stick over to the right, this aileron would go up. In the hover, this valve, when that aileron comes up, this valve opens. And because the aileron has gone up, meaning we want this wing down, this valve opens and lets hot air squirt upwards and blows the wing down.
Okay, this is how it looks like when I'm working on this Harrier project. The cool stuff about this char servo is they are programmable, and I'm using the DSO6, which is good for a lot of torque. Even the gears are metal. We're going to need to program it, and we're going to check the motion. We also need to continue with the Pegasus. So jaws there, but I still need to add these, and therefore I'm going to use the DS20 servo. This one is quite nice. And here's the fuselage part, where the filaments, they are quite they were in back order at Colorfab. So finally I've managed to print this piece for the fuselage part. The printers are already running 24/7, which is good, because we need still some fuselage parts and this very special tail part, but more about this later on. This morning I went to Wouters, because this is needs to be enforced with a carbon fiber tube. And guys, this build is going to be epic. By the way, we've still got the Boeing X-22 in progress, which has almost the same stabilization as the Harrier. So we built this actually now for a 8S setup, but together with my friends from RC Jetprint, we decided to go to 12S. I didn't even know that JP has also a 105 running on 12S. So this one is ordered, will arrive soon, and we'll let you guys know. So 12S setup for 105 can push 7.5 kilos, which is awesome. So guys, lots of work. We got also the tail section, which is starting to get shape. This one, compared to the version 1 Harrier, got a reinforced wing, so maybe we can try a slow flight. And even also the elevators are reinforced with a 4 mm carbon tube. So this one, version 2, is stronger compared to version 1 Harrier. If you want to see any videos, just scroll down in the video list and you will see some epic flights. It sounds amazing, and I'm really looking forward to how this works out. All of this, all thanks to my sponsors, and in this video especially PCBWay, but more about PCBWay later in this video. Those guys are awesome. So let's start programming the servo. We got a PWM config card tool. Just connect the servo. Then we say read config. Config succeeded. And what I'm going to do is lower down by 400. Let's say 1700 for this one. Upper. And lower is plus 300 is 1200 for upper. And then we say write config. What I also like on this servo, we can select soft start. Here we go. Now let's build the servo in. Boom, and here we go. So the Harrier was an iconic airplane, and it had these huge flaps, but also those ionic belly fins. So let's add them now. Another thing about the Pegasus, it's always hard to build it in and out. So what I basically do is slide it in from this side. The bottom pins will align with those connector holes, and it will, the motor will slide in into the inlet, and then we bolt it from upstairs. We fix it through this Pegasus unit, then it will be fixed and the motor won't run anywhere. So this is a 10 kilo push Schubler. It will run on 12S. According to the data sheet, it will pull like 135 amps at this voltage. So it's not, it's like, yeah, it's 2 kilos less than this Schubler. This one can do 12 kilos and this one 10 kilos, but it loses a draw less amperage. But let's see if the front EDF and the tail EDF can compensate the extra push I need. So in total, we should have, let's say, 13 kilos of thrust. But I'm losing a bit thrust of this bleed air channel. So excited. I really don't know what is the outcome. If you want to see more of this kind of videos, just let me know in the comments and make sure to hit that subscribe button. Let's go further. Okay guys, tonight we have help from my friend, the world famous Daddy. Hey! Thank you so much, buddy, for helping me cleaning those nozzles.
No problem.
So these will be attached at the Harrier later on in the video when we install the Pegasus. So this is going to be amazing. Okay, we'll continue cleaning. Well guys, so the Pegasus is ready to build in into the Harrier. Danny is testing the nozzle mechanism, still trying to figure out how it works, but he found this brilliantly, right? cool.
This works well, right?
This video is sponsored by PCBWay. PCBWay provides custom PCB services, but they also offer 3D printing, CNC machining, sheet fabrication, and many more. We use CNC and also 3D printing to make our projects. Mostly I use PCBWay to CNC cut aluminium parts for the F-35 landing gear. At PCBWay you can easily upload your file, select the material that you want and get a quote in less than 24 hours. Check them out at PCBWay.com. And let's go back to our video. Thank you, PCBWay. Okay guys, good morning. It's already 7 o'clock in the morning the next day. And we are going to continue with the Pegasus module. And today it's electronics day. So today we're going to also install the ESC. We're going to wire up the fuse. And the goal is to finish the tail part. And let's see how far that we are coming today. Okay guys, I think it's ready to build into the fuselage. The Pegasus is running smoothly. And now I'm doing a small test with the setup. So let's build in.
Let me show you how, if I move that rudder over towards the right, rolls towards you, then this reaction control valve here will open slightly. I'll move it now. Can you see it? Can you see it going? Okay, well, we've only got one thing left now.
Okay, guys, we came to a point that we're going to add a skill feature, which is called a puffer duct. If I'm wrong, just correct me in the comments. And this is actually a actuator which moving a valve for roll of Jumpjet. So I'll use a small EDF. This will blow air to the valve, and this will guide the direction during jaw momentum. So this is quite new. I don't know if it works, but we're going to find out in this video. So let's build this into the fuselage part.
And that's the pitch. How are we going to control this aeroplane in pitch? For example, we've all seen Harriers at air shows do bows. Well, the pilot needs to lower the nose to do his bow, which is raising the tail. Now, we need something blowing out under here in order to raise the tail when we move the stick forward, and that is indeed what we've got.
All right, so time to install the tail. I weld all those wires. I don't think it's really interesting to see how I'm wiring the cables. Also, the Pegasus is prepared, so we got our current measurement tool. So we are using a Castle Ice 160 amps 12S. According to the datasheet of Schubler, we're running at 135 amps max. So this will do. We got force cooling from the Pegasus. So yeah, let's complete this fuselage part by gluing the tail section in. Again, all servos are from Cha. I'm using the DS09 for the tail, 9 kilos of thrust, of torque, I mean. And these are really lightweight. This is what we need. Okay, let's start gluing. Guys, look at this. It's starting to really to look like an awesome Harrier. Some numbers, because I'm super curious about numbers. So I measured the weight of the fuselage and wings, and we're getting, including everything, and if I calculate the lipos, we are heading at 5.3 kilos, including all servos, wires, because I measured all the wires that we are going to use. And my deadline is 6 kilos. If I calculate the numbers for the pressure, so the 64 millimeter in the front, 64 millimeter in the back, and we got the Pegasus, which is giving me like 7 kilos. We are losing, there's an efficiency of 70%. We are losing some, so 7 kilos. We are heading for 9.4 kilos. And six by, you have to use the T factor, thrust off rate factor is 1.5. If you calculate with six, we are at 9 kilos. So, at this moment, it looks quite safe, but yeah, we need to still add the landing gear and the flaps and the roll mechanism and the rudder. So we got like 700 grams of play, 6 kilos. This model is 7 kilos. So again, we're pushing the limit of printing with the color flap filaments. And we're getting more lightweight every time. But it's also logical because we don't have the roll EDFs, all those cables extra, also the extra servos which are needed. So yeah, looking forward. Okay, and here we have our Pegasus module, almost ready to build in. I need to make some wire extensions, but it looks cool. I placed the char servo a little bit on side to gain the maximum rotation. And it looks, just seems to work really nicely. So I have to remove the nozzles, that's why I'm fitted with only one screw. And then we can build it into the fuselage. Really looking forward, guys. Okay guys, to give you an idea how big this model is, wait for it. Look at it. Whoa. So for next week, we're going to make a landing gear. Also printed with the bamboo lab filaments filled with carbon fiber. This is going to be nice. So make sure to subscribe and hit that like button, and don't forget to turn out that notification bell. Also next week, the Boeing X-32's new JP 105mm on 8S should arrive. So we're going to proceed also with the Boeing X-32 project, which is really stunning, almost the same flight setup as the Harrier. Guys, make sure to subscribe to follow this awesome build, and I will also posting on Instagram. So again, thank you so much, PCB Way, for helping out with this video. Also Charge Server for the most awesome lightweight servos. And yeah, we will guys see you next week. Bye bye.